स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आवर टॉपिक इज रिफ्लेक्स आर्क. द पाथवे दैट अ नर्व इम्पल्स टेक्स टू ट्रेवल फ्रॉम रिसेप्टर्स. सी दिस डायग्राम. दिस इज द डायग्राम शोइंग रिफ्लेक्स आर्क. द पाथवे दैट अ नर्व इम्पल्स टेक्स टू ट्रेवल फ्रॉम रिसेप्टर्स टू इफेक्टर्स. From receptors, it goes to the central nervous system. This yellow part I have shown. This is spinal cord. Okay, this is spinal cord. Yellow part is spinal cord. Receptors receive the stimulus and send to the spinal cord via sensory neurons, and then relay neurons passes the information and then the response is created, produced. Then this response is taken by motor neurons to the effectors. So the whole path that nerve impulse takes during reflex action is called reflex arc. Here is a sequence of events taking place. First, the stimulus goes to receptors, then to sensory neurons. From sensory neurons, through sensory neurons, it goes to spinal cord or brain. And I will tell you when it goes to spinal cord and when it goes to brain. If students listen carefully, if the reflex action is spinal reflex, spinal means it takes place, the stimulus is taken by hands, legs or our trunk, okay, then the reflexes are spinal reflex. They are controlled by this spinal cord. If the stimulus is received by our eyes, ears, nose, tongue, okay, I mean facial organs which are present on our face, okay, they are directly connected with brain. They are not connected with spinal cord. So those reflex actions are called cranial reflexes. Okay, when stimulus is taken by those limbs and trunks, then the message will stimulus will goes to spinal cord. If those stimulus are taken by eyes, ear, nose, then they will go to brain. So either it will go to spinal cord or it will go to brain. Okay, in both the cases the response is generated. This response is taken by then motor neurons and will be taken to the effectors. Then effectors then produce the response accordingly. Okay, so this is the sequence of events which take place during reflex arc. Now there are components of reflex arc. First is receptors, second is sensory neurons, third is central nervous system, that is brain and spinal cord both, and fourth is motor neurons, and fifth is effectors. Now I'm going to tell you the function of each one by one. I have labeled here. First component is receptors. These receptors, such as eyes, ears, hands, skin, receive the stimulus to initiate the nerve impulse. Then is sensory neurons. These neurons transmit the impulse from receptors to the central nervous system, that is brain or spinal cord. Then is third is spinal cord or central nervous system, that is third component. The impulse is transmitted from sensory neurons to motor neurons through relay neurons present in the central nervous system. However, no processing occurs during reflex action. Students, please note that no processing will take place. Just the passage of message is taking place. Next is motor neurons. These transmit impulse from central nervous system to the effector organs. Last is effector organs. These can be muscles, gland or organs that is activated by motor impulse, or you can say motor neurons, to produce suitable response to the stimulus. Okay, so these are the components of reflex are. Okay, now I'm going to tell you one more time the type of reflexes based on spinal cord and brain. There are two types of reflexes, two types of reflex action. These reflexes, or you can say reflex actions, are of two types: cranial reflexes and spinal reflexes. Cranial means brain. The reflex actions which involve brain, that is, if they are related with eyes, ears, tongues, for example, blinking of eyes, peristalsis in the food pipe. So these are cranial reflexes. And spinal reflexes, spinal means spinal cord. The reflex action which involve spinal cord. These reflexes can be related to trunk, limbs like hands and legs. And the examples of these reflexes will be walking, withdrawing of our hand. Okay, so there are two types of reflexes. Now, why these reflex actions evolved? Why they are evolved in human beings, in animals? Now our topic is evolution of reflex actions or reflex arcs. Reflex arcs or actions have evolved in animals because the thinking process of brain is very slow. It is not fast enough. So in order to produce quick and fast responses, students, during some events we need quick responses to avoid some dangerous situations. So in order to produce quick and fast responses during those conditions, during those events, the process of thinking by brain should not be involved. Okay, so in order to produce quick and fast responses without involving thought process of brain, reflex arcs have evolved and become an efficient way of functioning in animals. Okay, now our topic is nerves. What are nerves? You have many times heard this word, nerves. Okay, so students, nerves are the part of nervous system. They are made up of bundles of neurons. See, I have here, the nerves are the bundles of neurons. To understand how neurons are arranged in nerves, I want to show you a diagram. See this diagram? This is my imagination. This is my way of showing how nerves are made of, how neurons are arranged in a nerve. Suppose these are neurons. Okay, this is first neurons, this is second neuron, this is third neuron. They are placed one after the other as they are placed in our body. This is the synapse, the small gap between two adjacent neurons. And if I denote these neurons in this smaller way, in this smaller context, I am denoting these with these small structures. This is single neuron and this is dendrite, and these are nerve endings. And this small gap between them, this is synapse. Okay, so neurons are placed one after the other. They are forming a chain. Okay, then this chain can be represented by this single thread like structure. I called it single chain. When many chains of this kind arranged together, they form a single nerve fiber. So in other way, you can say, if you zoom this part, suppose if we enlarge it, okay, then we will get this structure. And if we enlarge this structure, zoom this structure, we will get this single thread like structure. And when this single thread like structure is again viewed, enlarged, if we see it in high power of microscope, we will observe this chain of neurons in which the single neuron is represented by this structure. Okay, so many neurons connected to form a single chain, and many chains are connected, are arranged to form a single nerve fiber. So in this way, neurons are arranged in nerve fiber. That is how nerves are formed. Now I want to tell you, there are three types of nerves. There are three types of nerves based on their functions. First is sensory neurons. These sensory nerves. Sensory nerves are made up of sensory neurons. These nerves carry impulses from receptors to central nervous system. Second is motor nerves. Motor nerves are made up of motor neurons. Okay, these nerves carry impulses from central nervous system to effectors. Next is mixed nerves. These mixed nerves are made up of both types of neurons, sensory neurons as well as motor neurons. They perform both functions, means they connect the body organs to the central nervous system. They perform both functions. They carry impulses to and from the central nervous system. Now our last topic today is nerve conduction is always unidirectional. I have explained this topic earlier also. This is very important topic, that is why I am repeating again. The nerve conduction is always unidirectional. It takes place in one direction only, that is from dendrites to cell body, then cell body to axon, then to nerve ending. If I draw its diagram, I have drawn its rough diagram. These are dendrites, from dendrites to cell body to axon, and then from axon to nerve endings. They do not go in backward direction, that is from nerve ending to axon to cell body and dendrite. It never goes in this direction is wrong. It always go in this direction. Why? Because the neurotransmitters are present in the nerve endings. Okay, because the neurotransmitters are stored in the nerve endings of neurons, which are released in the synapse. Synapse, you know, the gap between two adjacent neurons. This is synapse. So these endings release chemicals here in this synapse. These dendrites, the tip of dendrites, do not contain any neurotransmitters. So if the nerve impulse goes in backward direction, it will stop here. Because dendrite, the tip of dendrite, do not have any chemicals. So which is really, what chemicals will be released here? Okay, so it will go always in only one direction. So because neurotransmitters are stored in the nerve ending of neurons, which are released in the synapse and bind to the surface of dendrites of the next neurons to stimulate it. The dendrites have binding sites for neurotransmitters, but do not contain any chemicals which go backward to bind nerve endings of the previous neuron. That is why nerve conduction is always unidirectional. It takes place in one direction only. Okay, students, this is all about this nerve conduction. And the next topic we will start, that is control and coordination in human beings. Okay.